If you're looking to separate all of your audio sources, that being your music, your gameplay, your microphone, Discord, or any other audio source, then in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you're able to do that inside of Streamlabs OBS. So jumping straight to the video, the very first thing you want to do is open up Streamlabs OBS. And in case if you don't have this downloaded, I'm going to make sure that I have a link to this down in the description below so that you guys can go ahead and follow along. And so the first thing you want to do is come down the bottom left-hand corner. You want to select settings. You then want to go over to the audio tab. What we're going to do is just make sure that all of our audio settings are correct. And so the first thing you want to do is change your sample rate over to 48 kilohertz. So that way you can get the best possible quality. If you have to change this, just know that you might have to restart Streamlabs OBS. If that's the case, go ahead and do that. Once that's done, you want to leave your channels at stereo. And you're then going to change your desktop audio, and you want to make sure that is disabled. The reason why you want to make sure that's disabled is because this is going to play any and every audio source that is playing in the background or in the foreground of your PC, and you will have no control over any of the audio that is being played. So you want to make sure you disable that, because we're going to do all this manually. Now for your mic auxiliary, you want to set this to your microphone. So I'm going to go ahead and select mine right here. And you should see that your microphone is the only thing that is currently displaying under your mixer. Once that's done, you want to go over to the output tab. You want to make sure that your output mode is set to advanced. And you're then going to go ahead and select recording. Now from here, you want to leave your type at standard. You want to set your recording path as to where you want your recordings to go. Mine is going to be in my videos. Recording format, I'm going to leave mine at MP4. But if you choose to, you can set it to MKV. And then for your audio track, this is where you're going to choose like which track you want your audios to go into. So you want to make sure that you have anything other than track one, because track one is going to be for streaming. Now for this video, I'm going to go ahead and do 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I'm going to go ahead and take away 6. And then you're going to scroll up and you're going to go to the audios tab. And you just want to go ahead and change all of your audio tracks to 320. This is also going to help the audio quality. So once all of that is done, you want to go ahead and select done at the bottom. Now, one of the things that I like to do is create a nested scene. This is going to allow me to basically copy and paste everything that I put from this particular scene into any other scene without having to do any other work. So what we're going to do is just click on this plus icon. We're going to name this nested scene. And then in parentheses, we're going to do audio. Click done. A whole new scene has been created. And inside of here, we're going to go to the sources. We're going to click on the plus icon. And what you're going to look for is application audio beta. We're going to go ahead and select this. And so for the first audio source that we're going to separate is going to be music. Now, before we continue, there are two things that I want to go over with you. The very first thing is that you have to make sure you have all of your applications open before you add in this source. So, for example, your Spotify, your Discord, your games, all of that needs to be open first before you add this in. The second thing is that you want to make sure you open Spotify without any music playing. If you have music playing, then you're going to be locking in the application to that particular song, and then you're going to have to change it manually every single time. But if you open it up with no music and you select Spotify Premium, then it will be able to change the song no matter how many times you close Spotify and open it back up. So we now have our very first one, which is going to be our music. And so what we're going to do from here is we're going to add another source. This one is going to be specifically for Discord. So what you're going to want to do for Discord for this to work is that you want to make sure that you're in your Discord party. So for example, if you have a Discord server and let's say you have a voice channel that is specific for your streaming, then what you're going to do is you want to join that voice call. You want to make sure that you are selecting it, make sure it's highlighted. And you are then going to go here, you're going to add the source, which is the application audio beta. You're going to name this Discord. The window, you're going to look for your specific voice channel that you are currently in. Once you select it, you will see that Discord pops up right here, and you're now good to go. So whenever somebody joins your Discord and they end up coming in that particular voice channel, then it's going to work. Unfortunately, they do not have it set to whereas it can be automatic for any other voice call that you go into. So you're going to have to set it manually for it to work. So if you know for a fact that you're going to be in different VCs while you're live streaming, then you want to make sure you do that beforehand. So you can go ahead and you can do that now. And so once that's done, the third source that we're going to add is going to be our gameplays. And so you want to make sure that you have all of the games that you are ever going to play up. So what I'm going to do here now is I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to add my audio sources. So I'm going to, once again, plus icon, application audio beta. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to name this the title of the game that I want to associate this with. So you will now see that I now have my audio sources here. So on the left hand side, you will see that I have my microphone, which is completely separated from everything else. My Apex Legends audio, which I currently have uploaded. So if I were to just move this around, you will see that is currently being displayed there. I have my Valorant audio, my Monster Hunter audio, which is currently being played in the background because I do have that open as well. I have my Discord, and then I have my music, which is also currently being played. And so you will see that everything is currently separated right here. And so what I can do is I can now come back into my scenes. You will see that all of the audio sources went away. But in order for me to add it, what I'm going to do is come over to my sources. I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to look for scene, which says existing scene. Add the source, nested scene audio. And it will automatically bring all of the audio in this particular scene. And so if I ever created a brand new scene and I wanted to make sure that I have my audio in there, I can then just go ahead and follow the same method and I will automatically have all of my audio sources instead of me having to do that one by one. And so what we're going to do from here now is separate it to the point to where as if we are recording audio, we'll be able to distinguish what is what inside of our editing software. So what you're going to do is click on the gear icon next to your mixer. Now you will notice that we have all of these track numbers right here. And so track one is going to be strictly for your streaming. So if you don't want something to come through your stream audio, then you can go ahead and uncheck it. And you will not be able to hear it inside of your stream unless you decide to check it again. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and separate this. So we definitely want to have our microphone in our recording track. So we're actually going to leave one and two checked and we're going to uncheck the rest. And for all of our game audio, such as Apex Legends, Valorant, Monster Hunter, we want to make that as our second track. So we're going to uncheck two. We're going to do four and five. Now for our Discord audio, we want to make sure that it's our third track. So we're going to uncheck two and three as well as five. So these are going to be your tracks. So this is like, so technically when you're recording this, this is going to be track one. This is going to be track two, track three, track four. And so for our music, we want that obviously to be last. And so this is what it's going to look like when we record. So let me give you an example. So what I'm going to do is open up DaVinci Resolve, since this is the editing software that I use to edit all of my YouTube videos. I'm going to go ahead and create a new project. We're just going to name this testing. Now to import our media, what we're going to do is right click. We're going to do import media. We're going to go to where our videos are located. And then we're going to go ahead and input the video. We're going to go ahead and select change. This is automatically going to change it to the format as to what your video is set for. And then we're just going to go ahead and just bring this over. Once we bring this in, you will see now that we have four different tracks. Now remember earlier, inside of our Streamlabs, if we go to our mixer, right, we have four different tracks. One, two, three, four. We have four different tracks. So the very first one is going to be our microphones. And so what you can do is come into audio one and you can rename this microphone. You can name the second one, which is going to be our gameplay. The third one is Discord, which obviously is blank. And then the very last one is going to be music. And so before we even play this, what we're going to do is we're going to right click on the track. We're going to unlink it. So that way we can select each one individually. We can actually go ahead and get rid of the Discord since we're not using it anymore. And then you'll be able to now distinguish what is happening on each track. So you can mute this. And then You'll just hear your voice as well as the gameplay. To the left. You can mute the microphone and you'll just hear gameplay and music. Or if you just want the gameplay, then you can just mute everything else. And you can just have the gameplay audio. And so there you have it. That is how you're able to separate all of your audio sources inside of Streamlabs OBS. And so if you made it to the end of this video, or if you found this helpful, make sure you give this a big fat thumbs up. Make sure you guys go ahead and smash that subscribe button, as well as turning on post notifications so that way you do not miss a single video that gets posted up on his channel. And in case you want to learn the best settings for streaming, then make sure you click on this video right here, and I'll walk you through step by step on how you're able to do that using Streamlabs OBS.